it's good to have you back in time. I have prepared everything, but you need to double-check it. Hurry up! The captain is on his way here with another problem. Unsolvable again. He runs to me, and I console him. Like a child, really. It must be his age. Now, back to our business, which is at least solvable. Head to the platform. I've taken care of the rods. More instructions will follow once you get there.
Read this.
You know, I'm very glad. No, really. What did you expect? You're a pain in the neck. Both of you, yes, you and your sorry excuse for a ship. I'm so tired. Look, you're a big boy now. You can't play around forever. And I can't help you this time. Now go, please, go. Quit trying. Everyone has had it with you. No one wants you here. So there. He's been asking for it anyway. Just can't take it anymore.
We might lose a lot more if it's as bad as it looks. Bad for whom? For the crew? Where every member seems to think that navigating the North Pole is like a trip to the shops? In this place, the wind howls like a pack of wild beasts bellowing, "Go forth and behold." The beast leads you into the frozen hell. In you go, eyes wide open while the cold spreads down your throat and into your gut, where it forms a ball of ice. This is the North Pole's welcome. No marching band, no flags, no speeches. Instead, it shatters all your illusions, and suddenly, all the routine comforts of Mother Earth seem alien, half forgotten, like something in a dream. Only if this has happened to you can you truly understand the North Pole. And it will stay with you forever.